much longer battery lasts. better stay away from this dust a little bit, man. I already can taste it. Already there? We already here?
10 miles, yeah. It was on the short end of what I remembered.
Right.
Yeah, that's pretty easy. Not very sandy. It's fun.
Right.
It gets sandier on the other end. That's what I remember. But it's There aren't really any steep places. You get a couple over here.
So there I'm gonna end up on the street again. The one where we wanted to go in first. Ah, I see.
Yeah.
Yeah, I take that, it's fine, man. And then we stay in touch.
Yeah.
I was thinking for a moment maybe I should just do that black gap shit.
You could come down and look at it. I think there's a good chance you could do it, but
yeah, you never done it either, so you don't really know. We don't know.
Look, you're a good rider. I think you could probably do it, but yeah, it's a, you know, some risk. There's all more risk than doing this.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know.
All right, let me do it.
You know what we do? Exactly. You do it.
Yeah.
And then you let me. You know how I ride and all that shit. You know, you can say, hey, Gunther, you will make it through there.
I'll just say, hey, it's the same as these other roads. They just don't maintain it or something.
Right. Yeah, let me know. I'm interested. And I'm sure we're going to meet up again. I mean, it's just a matter of time.
Oh, yeah. We'll probably come back in the fall or next year.
Right.
I mean, now, yeah, I come a couple times. I love this place. It's great.
Cool.
Okay. So,
stay in touch.
The truck maybe an hour and a half from now.
Something like that. Maybe? We figure it out.
Yeah.
Maybe in between. It doesn't really matter. I mean, I wait there for sure. I mean, no worry about how long it takes or whatever, you know. Don't get stressed out.
Thank you.
All right.
Okay,
all right, man. basically forgot to take the receipt. Very nice views. Focus on filming the landscape. It's just beautiful. It's just totally minimalistic, and that makes it so beautiful. I mean, just look at that. On this road. I think Old Ore, what was that? On Wednesday we didn't see any cars. really that far anymore to the street. See those piled up gravel in the middle of the road, you gotta be careful. If you get in there, it might be a little bit swooshy. Temperature is perfect, 80 degrees, well it could be like a little colder, but I mean can't complain, no clouds, it's just beautiful. There to the pass and see. Sometimes there's a lot of people waiting, and it depends on the park ranger. A lot of times they just let motorcycles go through, or at least last time. But then another day I had a lady there, and she like, no, you cannot go, there's no parking. No parking. You can put your motorcycle anywhere. There were plenty of room actually later on, whatever. I don't know if I filmed that, because I already made a... I think I already have that on camera, I'm not sure. Battery might be empty by then anyway. I'm kinda sure it's empty by then. Might be empty now. No, still going. Well guys, I hope you enjoy. I know that my motorcycle videos, they don't really get that much views. It's mostly my car wrenching videos. Repair stuff. Of course it's more helpful, and this here is just recreational stuff. I was even thinking splitting my channel up and put those motorcycle videos onto a different one, but I still don't even have 1,000 subscribers, so hey, smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, so I get there at some point. Already mentioned yesterday I had a flat. The day before yesterday, on old Oro Road. But we managed to plug it and make it out of there. So we just like, you know, finished actually the road. But I was just somehow on the sidewall, and I really didn't feel good. Didn't hold air overnight. I didn't really want to go on another dirt track with that. So we stopped at a motorcycle shop here, a little small shop, and didn't have any 21 inch front knobbies. But there was a used one somewhere in a corner, so I asked him, hey, what about this one? Yeah, you can have it. It's kind of worn and messed up, but hey. I said, well, I don't care. I'll give you some money. But a worn bit of a worn tire than a leaking one. And yeah, it's a Kenda big block, got it on the front, and so far it's working. I can enjoy riding. I mean, the tire is pretty much totally done, but yeah, I don't care. It's not a race, you know. So once again, Big Bend, awesome. Highly recommended. Yesterday we went on a road, I can't even say what it was named. It went from Marfa down to Presidio or something, also a dirt road. Very, very nice and scenic. I filmed the whole dirt section of it, pretty much. And I'm gonna make a video out of this one as well, together with Andy. And it was just super nice, and we stopped at Presidio and had some lunch. That was a nice day. Those days, they go over, they go by fast, you know. Then you come back to the motor, you have a couple of beers, you talk, you go, oops, go back to sleep, and then you repeat in the morning with a smile in your face. I'm in third gear. Man, I really like this bike. I didn't really talk too much about it yet, but this Africa Twin is a... I don't know, maybe that is just me, but it feels like it's made for me. Now that I have the suspension all set up, it's kind of perfect. Just perfect for me. I cannot imagine doing anything else to it much. The only thing, sometimes that front screen comes loose from all the vibrations. I might want to look for some bigger, those rubber well nuts or whatever they're called, to maybe, like, you know, improve that. But otherwise, I'm pretty much done with this bike. I was thinking of getting a second set of wheels, tubeless Alpina wheels, to put street tires on it. Side on the, you know, it's a little easier, just swap the wheels around. But room in my garage is very limited, it's already packed. I don't know, I have to think about it. It's another $2,000. I kind of have already a lot of money in this bike, and it's some sort of a commitment, you know, when you spend that sort of money, you're gonna drive it for a few years, at least for somebody like me, who ain't have that much resources, you know. Those are all like-minded people here. The people who go to a park like this, that's so remote, they just must be cool people, I would say. I mean, this is for somebody who really likes nature, who likes, look at this, look at that. I hope the camera is still recording. Just look at the vast nothing, the unforgivable desert. The plants who make it here, they can make it anywhere. It's just it's a beautiful landscape. And I think I'm getting to the end of it. That street gotta be like maybe a mile or two from here. I don't know for sure, but I'm glad I turned the camera back on. Not sure what I'm gonna call that. Well, it's the Glen River Road. I don't even know the name again. Something with Glen. definitely a road for somebody who is who's a beginner. A beginner. Yeah, depending a little bit, of course, on your bike, but you know, this is nothing super technical. When you take your time, you're gonna make it easy through here. It's gonna be a great experience. There are amazing views, you know, just like this here. Still recording, but I'm gonna shut it off here and say goodbye, guys. And again, like and subscribe, and I see you next time, and be safe out there.